Hi there, and welcome. My name is Jason Boswell. I'm from CyberEz, and today I'm going to be talking to you about the file analysis suite. And particularly, I'm going to talk about sensitive data discovery of large volumes of data and how we use risk assessment using SmartScan to do a more strategic approach to that, dealing with very large volumes of data. So let's dig down into that scenario. So as a chief security officer, we need to find where sensitive data is with inside these large volumes. And these could be in Teams channels, OneDrive, Exchange, file systems. It could be in many places where unstructured data would reside. And I need to get the results very quickly. So when I'm dealing with very, very large volumes of data, and we know that as you can see below, we know the forces driving changes, volumes are growing rapidly, that the traditional approaches to analyzing that data mean that you sometimes have to wait a long time to get the results. And we need to know very quickly where to strategically approach to analyze that data. So where are the hotspots of where those sensitive data items are, where the sensitive files are, and then I can take the most appropriate action in the correct priority order. So once I'm going to use data discovery to know where my data is, where the sensitive data is, and then produce some reports and some analysis to then prioritize those further actions. Okay, so let's dig down straight into the product and we'll show you how we can do that. So here we have the file analysis suite. This is the landing home page. And I'm going to be concentrating on the connect tile and some of the analyze functions today. Because we're just going to be doing those initial discovery processes. So the first of all, we're going to be using Connect. So I'm going to click into Connect here, and you can see that I've analyzed some data already with inside the system. Those have been analyzed using my agent clusters in different locations, and I've been also analyzing some data directly from the cloud. The data is organized into different sources. So in my example here, I've got SharePoint, I've got some official records in Content Manager, I've got a number of different areas on the file system, I've got an Exchange folder with some mail system data, some data in Google Drive. So we've got multiple locations, but I'm going to be concentrating on this one down here. So this one that we're going to today, we're going to look in at some data that's in the Micro Focus SharePoint collection area. And we're going to use in the cloud cluster. So we're using cloud-to-cloud connectivity to analyze this data. So these are the sources of data I have in my system. And if I show you now the repositories, which is like a data subset of those sources, you can see that as I've analyzed some data already in different areas, file systems, records, but you can see there's different options on the analysis. We can do a full scan where we actually touch every single file and find, so we can very accurately know where every single piece of sensitive data is. But this takes time to execute if you're talking billions of files. Alternatively, we could analyze the metadata. Now, this is a quicker approach because you just gather in the metadata. However, it still takes time to touch billions of files. So the options here we can use, you can see this other option, we've got different smart scans. Smart scan, so I'm going to go down to the bottom here and show you my SharePoint site collection here. And I've got a team site where I wanted to do smart scan on that. So let's show you how this was set up. I'll go into the edit mode to show you how this was set up. Okay, so the first bit is you just added a name and you define where the source is. The key bit here is to define the location of this data. So of all the share, everything in SharePoint, so which is all our SharePoint sites, our site collections, our Teams collections, I defined this area using the path name. But because there could have been lots and lots of files in there, I wanted to get some initial results very quickly, I used the SmartScan option. Not only does this quicker, but it's also a much more cost-efficient approach because I'm only having to pay for the percentage of analysis, 10% of the data that to be analyzed. So using SmartScan, I've chosen 10% here, but we give you the option to choose a much bigger sample rate or a much smaller sample rate. It tend to find with very, very large volumes of data, you're quite happy to choose a smaller sampling rate. But for smaller rates, smaller volumes, you could choose a larger sampling rate. But that's totally up to you. You can choose whichever sampling rate you wish. Then we simply add the credentials, define the schedule, the attributes, define the grammar region, much like we would do with any repository. So I've defined that we're looking for worldwide grammars. We're looking for contact data, financial data, government data, on a worldwide nature. Once we've defined that, I would execute either on the schedule or a manual update, and that would run the scan. And this has already been achieved now, so I can go straight in and show you the results of that smart scan. So I can do it. The first thing we would look at is the heat map. So click on the heat map, shows me how the analysis has been completed. So you can see the breadcrumb trail at the top here, and we define in it's discovered the directory structure beneath this. So inside the structure, I've seen that in the main high level, we've got a finance section, we've got office party directory here, we've got HR, we've got reception, and we've got health. And the colors show me what's the density of sensitive data with inside those locations. So we've only sampled them. So we don't know exactly how many files have got sensitive data, but I can see, if I look at the contracts area, you can see of all the items that are in there, so there's going to be something like 260 items in there, 100% of them contain some form of sensitive data. So even though I haven't analyzed every single document, I can be pretty confident that we need to take some form of action with this area. Look at the office party folder here. 6% contains sensitive data. So that's like the one in the 17 items contains sensitive data. So there's a much lower risk with inside this area. And if we wanted to be really certain, we could actually click on the items and go deep down into the analysis to find out, you know, which one of them contains sensitive data with inside there. And I can see this with the highlighted with the red dot here. Most of them look to be images. So if we look at the file types, you can see that breakdown. Yeah, all 16 of them images, and one of them's a text document. The one that's a text document, you can see here, does contain some name and address information. So we have to be a little careful with the office party area, but perhaps we should perhaps prioritize on the finance and the health reports area, because they can contain the most dense information. We've got a high view of where my sensitive data is with inside the organization. What are my options? Now we can either do two things. We can either take some protective actions on that whole area, or we can create a new repository. So if I create, what I can do is do some, if I want to discover every single contract now, so it's shown me a sample and most of them are contracts. What I can do now is create a new repository. Instead of doing the sampling, we're going to do full scan. So here we can do the contracts folder. And we'll do the European, this time with it, we'll do the European template to look for sensitive data with the European grammars. And instead of doing smart scan now, I'm going to do full scan. So this will discover every single one of the files within inside this area, without having to discover every single one of the files in the office party area. So this is what I mean about a strategic approach to analysis. So this means that I'm quickly getting a view of where my sensitive data is, and then I'm taking action on the areas where the biggest priority is to take action. Okay, so this is how we just create a repository, and then this would allow me to kick off the analysis and find all the data with inside here, and then take a classification action against that data. Maybe we want to do some protection action activities to encrypt that data. Maybe we want to move this to another location in terms of, let's move this into the records area. These are contracts, they shouldn't be in a file system, they shouldn't be in SharePoint. In this particular area of the team site, these should be in the location, maybe in record center or content manager, where these can be properly controlled. Okay, So let me just go back to the start now, and we'll just summarize where we were. So we were able to find sensitive data using the connect section, and we used SmartScan to get the results very quickly and a much cheaper cost, and then analyze that data before and analyze that data to identify the areas that are of most risk, and then create subsets of them to then send to manage to take the appropriate action. Okay, thank you very much for listening, and I'll speak to you next time.